don't either.
I know, but at least I had like
how's the thumb?
Well, we're gonna say you guys panhandle those close games.
How fucked up is your finger?
I shot it right in the shoulder, man. I knew where I wanted to shoot it. And I shot it right in the shoulder.
I still forgot to shoot it. I
shot it right here. I hit it right here. I knew exactly what I
wanted. What makes it worse?
I don't know how to draw it.
I didn't walk in. Well, I wanted another chance.
I was going
to fade it, ramp it around.
I don't know. Yeah, that would be.
Because,
I mean, like, I would assume it's
going to
be like that feeling.
I don't have to.
First.
center had to
travel. Yeah, like, you're basically like this, you know? And so, like, I was trying to cover the whole episode, and every single time, their rotation was perfect. They would just throw a guy, and so, you know, just obviously. So, like, you know, there were a few times where you guys have either too many to cover down low, or you would have not enough. They would have four lined up back here on the corner. So they were, I mean, they were all over. I think we could, you know, I think we could actually benefit some of our guys. But like, I think our guys would benefit way down. No one likes to defend that. So, like, for, you know, so like for center, for example, like the Travis one I was talking about, or like how right wing, it's pretty much dot up, and then, what is it, it's a hash and in, so, you know, and then, you know, defense kind of doesn't really play a zone, but I think if our offense, had our zones down, that would eliminate so much.
I mean, we would, our line was doing fine on the defense, and then Ryan started coming over.
Yeah.
All the way over. And I'm like, what are you doing?
And there were actually a few offensive plays that actually didn't work because of that, too. Like, he would shoot over. If you were in your position, I think we actually could have that happen.
Yeah, they put me out of position because he left another guy open.
He was in now. I don't know if he was in there. I was telling him how on that second goal, I see the second guy. And he was like, yeah, I think that was my guy. I'm like, wait, how was that guy? And I'm like, this is his guy. I'm like, so either it was this guy or that guy.
He might just, I think he just doesn't understand what he does. Because I don't think he's cold. I don't think he's played hockey before. Well, if he has, he was little. I think that's what he said. He was little when he played. I don't think he understands who's covering.
I don't understand how that goal was scoring on him. But either he had a guy and he came down.
What was the
second? It was, the dude was the head on behind.
Was that when Steve took it around in the corner on the right?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know how that even went around. I got Steve to go on the outside that just when I got my stick down, he just like passed me.
Yeah,
and then it was in. I didn't
see it. And then according to Ryan, his guy shot down.
And that's his guy.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
But I still hit it.
Yeah.
And then that's how I'm confused. I'm like, okay, so I should you have stayed at the corner? Or was that your guy and my guy was still there? I don't even know.
He confused me. No, because I was on Steve when he brought it to the corner. You had it covered. And I was like, I think I have got the point, so I went back up. Because I got him to do 2 moves to the outside. And then like, I had my stick to try and block the pass. And then he somehow just like backhand shovel.
I wouldn't mind working on like, I think some of our guys, like, for example, I think we could benefit from knowing, like, the zones to how to work out.
Yeah.
So, like, that would really help. So, like, if he's on wing, he should know that he's got to be up in the, you know, zone area. And then on breakout, watch a couple videos like that.
Dude,
when I started in Wood Ridge, and I watched,
when we did the first tournament back in January, I just went online and watched it.
Yeah. It's available for all positions.
Yeah. I didn't know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah. And even sometimes, I mean,
I don't know if the other, you know, like, depending on, like, there's basically a line, and if it's on this side, the D on this side should be over there, and the D should be in the middle, and the other side should shoot. So
yeah.
The other thing about the guy.
And then center should shoot up to between the dots.
Yeah. So there always should be like a
yeah.
And then on for the offense, it's the same thing basically.
Yeah.
Have whatever side you just follow until you get to the middle.
Yeah.
That way you prevent it.
Actually, like, yeah, I mean, it's really
you
simple when you're
in it. Yeah. And then behind the net, you just gotta like,
right. No, I ignore behind the net too, because like center, you're actually, you know, if for example, if like Tony had the puck, like when he was left, maybe he had the puck and he was stuck in the corner. Realistically, what you should do is cut him out. But like in this league, realistically in this league, there's really no reason to do that. I mean, like it might hurt, but there's a chance of
most part, I just try to block.
Yeah.
And then for D, when you're just playing D, I mean, I just go to the side, like,
right.
across.
Yeah, like basically that whole area in the middle, you just want to picture the ball.
And then that goes back to like the wings when we're breaking out. They should already be in that point area up there. And, you know, they should when we get the possession of the puck. They should both go to the
side. Yeah, because this time I'm running back and I have nowhere to go.
Right.
Yes.
They should both go to the blue line against the boards. Yeah. Blue line against the boards. Both of them.
Yeah.
And then, you know, once the breakout pass is made, say it goes to that guy, he should laser out. And then the center should follow up. Or vice versa. It can be the center first, too. But, you know, if we
do that, if I'm running this way, I'm going up there, there's nowhere to go. So.
Yeah. So, I mean, I think, like, because for you guys, I think I agree actually with Kevin. I think we're playing great defense right now, but I think what we're struggling with is that half our offense doesn't know. Like, I'll tell you right now, the two guys that are normally on my line, they could really use some lessons. Like, if we...
Like, and maybe, is on your line?
Chris... I think next time they're here, actually, I'm going to take a moment and just be like, yo, let me help you out with some zones. Because, like 2 weeks ago, I ended up watching more videos. To like, because I was playing center out here every night now. You know, it's like, okay, I'm going to watch some center videos. You know, so.
Yeah, center's so
I mean, when you look
to the right, all they have to do is come to the back.
Yeah, yeah. No, and I play right wing on Wednesdays. But I mean, like that, you know, compared to that, it's really difficult. But I mean, what I didn't know before today, actually, I found that out today, is the trapezoid in the middle. It makes a diamond. It's like center, out to the dots, and then back in towards the goal. So it's like a diamond of coverage. And it's like, that's a big space. I mean, that's a lot of space.
Yeah, that makes
And then on the breakout, it's dots all the way down. So it's like, that's a lot of space.
Whatever.
I don't care. I mean, that bothers me. Whoa, nice.
That was
I think one day, you know, like an early game, I think we should seriously just sit here and like the dudes that want, like maybe we can just kind of like do something like, you know, the guys that want some tips and tricks for like defensive zone coverage, you know, lift it up or something like that. Because I mean, I don't want to sound like like I know it all, because I don't. But like I think, like based on what I know from defensive coverage, I think a lot of us need help with a lot of offense. So
I know I could have done better than that.
You were actually in zone though.
Yeah, I was in zone.
Hey, I was in zone.
Now see, I'm talking to Pete about mainly like, because on a normal Monday night, I have Matt and Chris on my line at center. It's like, and those two guys both have, their zones are a little too wide almost. It's really tough to, I mean, that makes my, like how I was talking about the triangle or like the trapezoid there.
They also don't try to get to the space.
Yeah, because that makes my center trapezoid so much wider too. And I have to cover a ton of space. I don't know, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I mean, I was on my guy at the point. I may have still been outside the zone, but my D-man was also out there with me. If he came in, I came in. I wasn't just leaving on the zone.
Yeah,
the only times I left him on his own when I ran to the point to try to stop the shot was because Ryan was all the way the fuck over here.
And that's what I'm saying too, is like, you know, I think Ryan was, he wasn't really, actually he wasn't playing a wide zone, he was playing a deep zone, and that's dangerous too.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
It's not that he wasn't putting the effort, he just didn't know where to go.
Yeah. No, I think if he knew some more tips and tricks, it'd be useful. I mean, like, I found out, actually, for right wing, I found a neat little trick where if they have possession on your side, or, like, if they have possession here, you just back up so, like, you can see the dot, stick your stick out. So, like, if I'm at this dot, I can stick my stick out, and then I can see the puck carrier this way, and I can see my D-man this way. So I'm basically in between two of them, and you can lay it. And then on the other side of the ice, you step in, and you can go a little further towards the center. And it, like, I've actually intercepted a lot of passes just using that. I mean, like, that's really helpful to have, like, a good zone. I don't know. I mean, it's not like this is professional, but I think, you know.
Yeah, but it's so annoying.
Right, right.
Ooh!
That's a curveball. That's pretty sweet.
He saw it, too.
That was, oh, that was crazy, though, because it shot up and then just, like, curved in. Oh, he's, yeah, he's pissed.
Thank you.